That tune was called Come Dance and Play, and that was written by Isaac Bates Sr., a Shaker brother. And this is a hammered dulcimer. This instrument was built by Michael Allen of Cloud Nine Instruments in Ostrander, Ohio. The hammered dulcimer was and continues to be a popular instrument for playing dance tunes, and it's particularly due to its music box sound and its percussive piano-like effects. It's unclear when the first hammered dulcimer was brought to America, but the earliest reference we have is from Judge Samuel Sewell, who reports hearing it played in Salem, Massachusetts in 1717. Dulcimers were pretty popular, common domestic instruments at the time, and it's no doubt that they were brought to the colonies from England, where they had been used in street music. Hammered dulcimers were quite common here in Ohio. During the late 1850s, two factories producing hundreds of dulcimers per year were located in Sherman, New York. Both located second factories on the Kentucky side of the Ohio River and had agents as far west as Missouri and as close as Lewis Center, Ohio, selling them. Traveling salesmen and the makers themselves sold thousands of instruments in the country. The nature of manufacture and distribution was different for hammered dulcimers than it was for the piano or banjo or guitar. Dulcimer makers and manufacturers were located in rural areas rather than urban, and they sold them directly, either through salesmen or by themselves. And by making and selling his dulcimers, Michael Allen is following a long tradition here in Ohio. Portability and simplicity made the dulcimer much more practical than the piano for many settlers. These attributes made dulcimers popular with the lumber camps of Maine and Michigan, and it's still referred in some parts as a lumberjack piano. You might also hear them called a whamadiddle or a hackbrett, and hackbrett is German for chopping block. The name dulcimer comes from the Latin and Greek words dulci and melos, and combined they have the meaning of sweet tune. And that is also why the Lap or Appalachian dulcimer is called the same thing. But these two instruments have very, very different history of form, of sound, and evolution, and even in manner of playing. Both have strings that are stretched across a sound box, which classifies them both as members of the zither family. The plucked dulcimer relies on shortening or fretting or stopping the strings to produce the many pitches that you need for a tune. In the case of a hammered dulcimer, a single string or a group of strings called a course is tuned to a specific note. All evidence seems to indicate that the Appalachian dulcimer has only been with us for about 200 years and had its origin in Germany. The origins of the hammered dulcimer are much more ancient and undoubtedly from the Near East, where instruments of this type have been made and played for perhaps 5,000 years. The santur and santarium are names early applied to such instruments, and they're probably derived from the Greek psalterion. Today, the dulcimer is known as the santuri in Greece, and the psalterion and santur in India. And from the Near East, the instrument traveled both east and west, and Arabs took it to Spain, where a dulcimer-like instrument is depicted on the Santiago de Compella Cathedral relief in 1184 AD. Its introduction to the Orient came much later. The Chinese version is called the Yan Qin, which means foreign zither, and they don't remember playing it until about the 19th century. It seems logical also that the dulcimer provided much of the inspiration for the piano. Harpsichords were quite limited in their quality of expressiveness, and the clavichord was severely limited in volume. The pianoforte was the result of attempts to overcome these issues, and the solution was to excite the strings with leather or felt hammers, as we do on the dulcimer. One early form of the piano even bears the name of a 17th century Prussian dulcimer called the Pantaleon. Thank you for your interest in the hammered dulcimer. I'll close today with a tune composed by another Shaker, Elder Joseph Brackett Jr. in 1848, for what the Shakers called a quick dance. It was sung and danced in lively tempo in their worship services. Brackett only wrote one verse to this tune, so any extra verses you hear are non-Shaker in nature. Thanks again for your interest in the hammered dulcimer.